I strongly advise you to go through all these things, all the Trinity. What are this Trinity? I have told you, my dear students, number one, 2021, current affairs. What is that book? You know that. 21 to 2022, current affairs. What is that? What is that, my dear students? That is invariably your budget. This is invariably your economic survey. 2020, 2021, this is 21, 22, 2 years current affairs. Added with that, 1 year exclusive things about India. In India, 2021. All these things are UPSC books, my dear students. I strongly suggest you, neither of your any coaching institutions material will come in the examination. UPSC is fair to many extent. That is the reason why he is picking the questions from NCERT. That is the reason why he is picking from the most available, most authenticated books, which are widely available to, equally available to all, like your economic survey, budget, and India Air book. You want to succeed, my dear students, please master these three things. This is the key. This is the secret. If you are reading newspaper daily for a while, you decrease the amount. If you read, don't read for a few days, nothing will happen. But I'm not saying that you shouldn't read. What I'm saying is, you first master these three books. You first master these three books. Afterwards, then only you'll be having the mastery. Then only you'll be having the grip. Today in this session, I'll be discussing what are the things you have to do with respect to civil service preparation, as with respect to India Air book is concerned. My dear students, I have been reading this India Air book since 2006. I have cleared prelims 7 times, that is, I have written mains 7 times and went to interview thrice. Major part of the success I attribute to these three books. Because, my dear students, if there is any difference between a person who passes the exam and who doesn't pass the exam, both have put equal amount of hard work. Then both have put equal amount, both have seriously prepared. Then, my dear students, the difference will be just 1 or 2 questions, my dear students. If a person, for example, question number 99, if one person does this right, the person who clears will be getting 2 marks here. If the same question another person does this wrong, you'll be losing 0.6. Means, what is the difference? One question, right or wrong, will make 2.6 marks difference. So if you make like this 10 questions, there will be 26 marks difference, my dear students. 2 questions difference means there will be 5.3 marks difference. Why I said is, UPSC is picking questions from these things. Don't take chance, especially with respect to this prelims, because only 100 questions are there for you. In that, almost 30% of the questions, almost God only knows. See, these questions will be very, very difficult, my dear students. Why I'm saying is, coaching institutions take 3 to 5 days to come up with the answer key. To come up with the answer key, even then there will be plus or minus 5 questions. Ambiguity. See, 5 days they have taken, even then 5 questions they cannot answer. And even after the answering, there is a variability of plus or minus 5 questions. Not only with any institution or any individual, it is true with anyone. See, 5 days you are taking all the resources a institution has, it is using all the experts for who are been teaching for 10 years, 20 years, all will be there. They can't answer 5 questions. Even the time, your Google, everything is given. Definitely there will be 30 questions you cannot answer to a greater extent. You have to make a guesswork there. In this regard, even 3 to 10 questions will matter a lot. I strongly say that with these three books, 10 questions aana hi hai. They will come and they have to come. Having said that, my dear students, we at an academy, we are democratizing the education, my dear students. We are democratizing the education. We are giving many things for free, my dear students. Just download our app. Just download our app. We'll be having access to many, many things. We are giving many things free on our app. Other than that, if you want like structured courses, live classes and live tests and unlimited access, you have to go for something other than free, that is your plus course. If you want to have a personal coach assigned to you, you need to take iconic subscription, my dear student. So if you want to get free coaching, please download the app. My dear students, I was astonished. Many students, they come and they listen the things on YouTube, but they have never downloaded the Unacademy learners app. I found that not fair, because okay, we are not forcing you to join. Download the Unacademy learners app. There are very, very important things. Top educator like Leave It Apart, Brunal Patel, he is taking special classes there. You can watch many things. Rakesh Verma, a senior IAS officer, is taking special classes there. You can watch them for free. Then what are you waiting for? Download the Unacademy Learners app and use my promo code Buddha. And if you want to get subscription and get 10% discount, use my promo code Buddha10. My dear students, this is a brief about me. I am a national faculty, a plus verified educator on an academy. This is Raghu with you. My dear students, at the very early age, I have written many books. The whole inspiration, guidance, everything goes to M. Lakshmi Kant, the stalwart of polity. He's the person who guided me how to write the book. He's the person, if I have got some success in my civil service preparation, I strongly owe major part to Lakshmi Kant, sir. He told me where, what UPSC is doing. That is the reason his book is unbeaten even today. With the pen name of Buddha IAS, I have written many books. In this, these are the latest books. If you want to follow me, you can follow me in this link on Unacademy, my dear students. Not only me, top educators like Brunal Patel, Roman Saini, Prakash and many more are teaching at Unacademy. If there is a single place where top educators are teaching, then it is invariably Unacademy, my dear students. These top educators have created more than 15,000 courses, not videos, 50,000 courses which comprehensively cover the syllabus. My dear students, I have already told you there is a plus subscription where you will be having structured courses, unlimited practice test series and live classes. All these things you can avail a 10% discount. It will be just costing you 64,000 if you take 2 year subscription, my dear students, with my promo code Buddha10. Similarly, use my promo code Buddha10 and you will be having access to a personal mentor who will guide you through. Where we will be having a study planner, personalized feedback and daily mains question and answer and also personal coach. My dear students, go for 1 year or 2 year or 3 year things. In all these cases, use my promo code Buddha10. You will get 10% discount. Same with optionals, my dear students. With the new year, we have started many, many new batches. We are coming with 1 year, 2 year, bilingual, English, Hindi, all these things. Top educators like Brunal Patel, Ashish, like your many, many top educators who have taught in major institutions like Vajiram, all are teaching at an academy, my dear students. What are you waiting for? Get a subscription, my dear students. Whether it may be NCRT batch or anything, on February 1st, we are starting many, many new batches. And you know one thing? We are starting with a new completely weekend batch to cater to the needs of working professionals, my dear students. If you are a working professional, what are you waiting? On weekends, we can complete the syllabus, whole syllabus. The last days, the countdown has begun, my dear students. January 31st is the last day. If you have not upgraded, do upgrade to iconic subscription. And also we have got a combo pack where we have just combined the optional and also the GS port. GS and also optional, my dear students. Here we are giving optional choice for plus and iconic. If you take both plus, we also have offer for you. If you take both plus, we'll be having 42%, my dear students, 42% for 3 years, 1,20,000. Just imagine, 36 months, and for that you are just paying 1,20,000. In that, prelims, mains, interview, optional, quiz, live classes, unlimited access, all these things. My dear students, I challenge you, this offer you won't get anywhere. If you are thinking of taking classes, taking exam in 23, 24, 25, make an appropriate chance. And every day, an academy is growing, new top educators are coming, and what you have now will never decrease, it always increases. Be with a winner, you will be a winner, my dear students. Having said that, let's begin our class, India 2021. What is India 2021? What to read and what not to read in these things? This has become a million-dollar question to many of the students. Many say that it's not that important, it's very bulky, it's no time to read this. Very, very important thing which you have to consider in this respect is the time available, my dear students. One of the reasons why students and the toppers are like not having clarity about this book is, this book will be released in February 3rd week. Last year it was released in 19th. It was released on 19th February. From February, March, April, May, June is the examination preliminary. Hardly will be having 100 days. They say that this is a book of 900 pages. My dear students, when we started, it was having 1400 pages. Now the things have changed because a lot of internet has grown, everything. But the significance of India Yearbook is even today is there. My dear students, don't be afraid of this 900 pages. In this can be squeezed to some 300 to 400 pages. And you know, my dear students, this is useful for all exams. In civil service exam, take prelims, mains written, mains interview, all in one book. If there is something like all in one book, then this is your India Yearbook. You are reading newspaper daily, how much marks you are getting? How useful is this? My dear students, this is the high time you master India Yearbook. Along with your newspaper, you students, my dear students, please master this trinity. They always ask, my dear sir, what is that current affairs we have to read? Sir, from when to start? What to read? Sir, I am appearing in 2021. Exam is in June 27. From where should I begin the current affairs? Should I begin from January 2021, or shall I go 1 year, like June 2020, or shall I start from January 2020? What should be the thing, my dear students? The approach itself is wrong. You have to start with the latest. You have to start with the latest and you have to come back. What is the latest current affair available to you? What is the latest current affair available to you? That is your budget. It is giving you what India will be doing for the next 1 year. Budget 2021-22. Please master it. Based on that, you come down. Next 1 year, what India has done already. Budget 2020-21, master it, 2 years current affairs, add it with India Yearbook, All these things should be done keeping in mind of your syllabus. Otherwise, simply you will be completing the books, nothing you will be assimilating, nothing correlating, nothing connecting the dots will be happening, my dear students. So, keep the syllabus in your mind. Put all these things, assimilate all these three. This trinity, three books are the UPSC books, these are the game changers. Economic survey, my dear students, I repeat, 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 and I say, UPSC is directly picking questions in economy mains, in prelims. That is the reason why I have taken up this. Is it clear? Any doubt with respect to these things? If you have got any doubt, please let me know. I'll be very happy to answer you, my dear students. If you have got anything, please let me know. Please tell me. Economic survey, a very, very important thing. Government of India source. Direct questions have come. Then India 2021, direct questions have come. And also budget, very, very important. And my dear students, all these things you have to, I'm repeating these things, all these things you have to internalize in February. Otherwise, now or never. Coming forward, what to read, how to read India Yearbook, do's and don'ts. In that, my dear students, first of all, you should know this one. This is an Government of India publication. It is published by Publication Division, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. This is the information given in the book itself. It is a reference manual. Government itself says that this is a reference manual compiled by New Media Wing. Very, very authentic book, my dear students. This is a thing which is given by the end of the book. Since 2021 is not yet released, my dear students, in 2021 also this holds good. What is this India Yearbook? A reference manual. This is a reference manual. A reference annual is comprehensive digest. It's a comprehensive, means all encompassing, covering digest of country's progress in different fields. Every year, annually, you'll be having this one. The book deals with all the aspects of the developments. All deals with all the aspects of development. Maybe with rural to urban, industry to infrastructure, science and technology to art and culture, economy, health, defense to education, mass communication. See, these are the things which are there in your syllabus, my dear students. Especially your GS3. GS3 has science and technology. GS3 has economy part. Everything it is there in the syllabus. The sections on general knowledge which are given at the back, general knowledge, current affairs, sports, and important events which are given at the fag end, maybe chapter number 13, I suppose, they are must read for comprehensive understanding of these fields. With its authenticity of facts and data, the book is a treasure for students, researchers, and academicians. My dear students, I strongly suggest you to go through this book. If you have not done, please. A point of caution for you, my dear students, if you have failed in last examination prelims, now if you are still reading some things which are not related to prelims, I'm not saying like completely, say for example GS1, GS2 and your GS3 are related to prelims, you read them, not your optionals. If you have not gone through India Yearbook, please do complete it at the earliest. And as I told you, nearly one-fourth of the syllabus or one-fourth of the things which are present here are static. They never change almost. So, my dear students, please go through all these things. And this is the content which is there. This we will be having 32 chapters and an appendix. See the things. Everything it is given to simplify you. These are the chapters. Please tell me a topic here which is not there in your syllabus. Land and the people, it will be covering the geographical things. National symbols, it is your general knowledge and it's of great importance. We, the citizen of India, we should know all these things. Here, polity, here, no, many things with respect to constitutions are given. Here, you also have things about Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs is given. You'll be having data with respect to Cabinet Secretary. You'll be having data with respect to Ministry of Personnel. These are the things. See, your geography is part of geography is here. National symbol important, and also Indian polity. Polity is given here. From then on, all the things, all the ministries are given in alphabetical order, my dear students. Agriculture most important. Last time, lot of questions, nearly 8 to 10 questions have come in prelims. Culture and tourism, nowadays it is getting lot of importance in prelims and mains. Basic economic data, like all the indices, how they are prepared. Commerce, defense, very important. Education, energy, environment, a subject which is conspicuously mentioned in prelims and mains written. Finance, the whole budget, all this process, finance, economy. Food and civil supply, once again, very important and related to agriculture. Health and family welfare, housing, India and world. The world affairs. Everything, law and justice, once again, relating to your polity and also security. Here, various security forces, all these things, data is given. And law enforcement agencies, data is given. Planning, rural and urban development, science and technology, transportation, water resources, welfare, youth affairs, everything is given, my dear students. Nothing is waste here. And once again, my dear students, with respect to this thing, states and union territory data, with respect to all states is given, my dear students. All the states and union territories. Very important, very authenticated. And also in 78 pages, they will cover 1 year daily current affairs. General information where we'll be having with respect to all presidents, Nobel laureate, prize winners, all these things. Very important, my dear students. In this, once again, my dear students, I'll tell some of the things what you have to do and some of the things what you shouldn't do. In this direction, my dear students, one of the foremost important thing for you will be these things. Please complete those things which are static portion. These are static portions. Please complete it. States, static portion, complete it. General information, static portion, complete it. Even before, it will be released in February end. If you are writing for 2021, this is the high time that you complete these things. And in all other cases, only 2 to 3% change will be there. Until and unless they make new schemes, and also they won't be adding the things in between lines like this. They'll be adding in separate paras. You can make it. So, my dear students, please start with the Sir India Yearbook 2021. Yes, is this? This is I'm speaking about India Yearbook 2021, which will be released in February. Third week. Last year it was released on February 19th. This is the book which you have to study, my dear students, not any other book. This is the only India Yearbook. Because it is popular and because it is from which this is a UPSC book, many have come up with India 2021 Yearbook, all these things. This is the real India Yearbook. This is very, very important, my dear student. If you are thinking of preparing into appearing in 22, 23, all these things, you start now itself. Even if you are appearing in 21 examination, please start now itself. I am giving you the clue. 1/4 of the things never change. I have been reading this India Yearbook from 2006. And I have been teaching for the past 5 to 6 years also. I have written books on this one. The things which I have made in bold and red, they never change almost until and unless new state is formed, something like that. These are the general things, stationary things. See here, this is 100 pages and this is more than 200 pages. See, already More than 300 pages you can master any time. Don't wait for these things. Then you will be left with another 600 pages. This 600 pages can be squeezed to like 100 to 150 pages. That's it. There's no need for you to be afraid. But the thing is, you have to start now. It's now or never. At least what I say is, don't, if you don't read also not a problem, you should have an original copy with you. Not only that, if you read India Air Book very fast, your comprehension will increase. It will be very, very useful for your prelims examination also. You can go, you take an India Air Book, go with a lightning speed, marking all the things. Is it clear? So India Air Book is must. If you are preparing and if you don't want to take chance, read it now. Reading newspaper, all these things can be secondary. Okay, you are reading newspaper daily, like that you read India Air Book daily. You finish some 10 to 20 pages. In another 10 to like 1 month, the book is over. Mark it off. Second revision will be very, very easy. It will be fast going. I am talking about India Air Book 2021. Oh, very good of you. Okay. Next, see here, general information. This is the content which is there in India Air Book. General information. In this, see here, all the presidents and table of presidents with respect to president, prime minister, all these things. All Indians president, vice president, prime minister, chief justice, civil awards, Bharat Ratna awards, Padma awards, all these padaks, all these things, not only that, Nobel rights, all these things. My dear students, I am not saying that you will, like, these are very, very important. What I am saying is, don't take chance. What if one question comes about the normal Nobel laureates? Nowadays, the importance has decreased, especially true. It's true. But, my dear students, it is very, very important at least to know. Just have a glance of these things. These are important things. See, last, all the amendments are given. Is it now important? Sport awards, adventures, all this in Sahitya Kala awards. So India Year Book is very, very important, my dear students. It will be releasing in another 15 days. But you can start reading now itself the previous 2020 India Year Book. Okay. In the last, in appendix, you will be having Government of India, Cabinet Minister, all these things. There is no need for you to read all these things because they won't ask who is the minister, all these things directly. And also members of parliament, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. If you are interested in politics, you can just go and see where is the, like from which district, which minister has come, which MLA, MP has come, all these things. It is all about MPs. Okay. Moving forward, India Air Book. I think you are all aware of India Air Book. Is there anyone who is not aware of India Air Book released by Government of India? India Air Book, every year Government of India Publication Division releases one book that is known as like India 2021 for this year. Last year we had India 2020. If any of you are not having idea of this, please let me know. I will just brief the things for you. Hope you have got the idea of India Air Book. See, three important books are there. Three important sources are there for your preparation. They are Economic Survey of, it will deal about everything what we have done in the last 1 year. So it is known as Economic Survey 2020-21. Means till everything with respect to last year till next budget. Next is important is your budget. It is known as 2021-22 because it is about future, next year. So 2 years current affairs. Add with budget, India Air Book, it will be having each and every department, each and every ministry you will be having. We have shown you in this, there is nothing which is waste. See the things. This is the exact real book copy. See here, just see the things. agriculture, cultural tourism, basic economic data, commerce, defense, all are there in the syllabus. Very, very important, my dear students. See, from A, agriculture till youth, these are nothing but all the things done by your ministries. All ministries, they are put together. My dear students, with these three things, what I have told, like budget, economic survey, and India yearbook, I say that 10 questions definitely come in your prelims. And you can answer most of the questions in mains examination, especially with respect to your GS3, where the sources are lacking. Say, for example, your history, polity, economy, environment, all these things, you have got some sources. But for GS3, sources are lacking. That source is your India yearbook. But problem with India yearbook is updated till only September or December 2021. Though the book is named India 2021, nothing will be there which is having a current affairs related to 2021. Because as you are aware, like it will be, as I told, it will be released by February 3rd week. So they will take at least 1 month, more than 1 month to prepare the things. Afterwards, assimilate, correction, proofreading. So maximum December 2020 will be the current thing. That is one of the lacunae. Second lacunae is, there's a lack of flow in this one. I repeat, there is lack of flow in India yearbook. Lack of flow in India yearbook. Say, like I told you, like first chapter will be land and the people. You don't know from where they will suddenly start, like flora. Suddenly they will start fauna. They will start with physical things. Then geological they will go. Not only that, second chapter is symbols, national symbols. Okay, a bit easy and small. Afterwards, polity, chapter number 3. You won't come to know like where the constitution part has stopped and from where your cabinet secretary part has started, or from where your parliamentary affairs ministry things have started, or from where and under what, under these things, what are the subheadings. And also, ministry of personal things are also covered here. So it is all about ministry, but these things are lacking flow, and also there is no proper heading and subheading. For that, you won't be knowing where the real heading stops and where the real heading starts. Say, for example, ministry of like cabinet secretary or ministry of parliamentary affairs. They will give some introduction about parliamentary affairs and they will start some 5-6 programs. Even the size of heading and subheadings are not conspicuously made small and big so that people will understand. These are the major drawbacks, and this is the reason mastering this is very difficult. But my dear students, it is a very, very important book. I have been reading this book since 2006 and I have got a little mastery because of doing all those things. If you like, trust me, you can come with me in a very few days. Like at least it will take few, like maybe 1 month. I'll make sure that you will master this one completely, India yearbook, because I know like how to go through these things. There is a lack of flow in the content. If you read, you may find it difficult if you are a beginner. And also headings and subheadings, all these things I have made through. So to overcome these things, what you have to do with respect to the data, you have to update with budget. Because here only till December 20, budget is futuristic. Add this one, lack of flow in content. So what you have to do, you have to have a bird view first. First you look into those things, what is there in the chapter. Afterwards you read, then you will come to know what is there. Okay, then you can make the flow. Lack of proper headings. That is also the answer. Once again, is first have a bird view, then you will get what is there in the chapter, then it is very, very easy for you to understand the things. Okay, fine. India yearbook is one of the important thing, but and also, my dear students, once again I strongly reiterate the things for you, and once again I say this to you, my dear students, before reading India yearbook, before reading your economic survey, before reading your budget. Please don't read without seeing the syllabus, because simply your mind cannot understand those things. If the syllabus is there in your mind, mind will assimilate, mind will correlate, mind will connect the dot. Okay, we have got environment syllabus here. Environment things are there in economic survey also. Oh, okay, I thought that economic survey means only economic things. Economic survey has, my dear students, even environment related things. 10% is environment related things. 10% is agriculture related thing. There are many things about sustainable development, everything which are there in budget and also in your economic survey. So what I say is, first read main syllabus, afterwards you read the book. So as I always say and I stress you, Ram Kumar Reddy and Singh and many others, Siddharth, please first read the syllabus. I strongly advocate you. Morning you get up and read 5 minutes syllabus. Afterwards you read newspaper. Then your mind will assimilate, okay, this part is this. Because that is the way you have to write in the examination. That is the way you have to prepare. You don't know why simply completing, okay, today's newspaper I have completed. Today's newspaper, like daily editorial analysis I have completed. This is not fair. Your brain cannot do these kind of hard works. So what I request you all, see, you please do this one for my sake. Say February, I was asking 3 weeks, I will just ask 4 weeks, February whole month, or at least till February 14th, 2 weeks, daily 5 to 10 minutes you read syllabus. Morning after getting up, you are not reading anything, you just read the syllabus. I have told you in all my sessions how to simplify the things. You simplify the thing, just read 5 minutes syllabus. My dear students, in 1 month, in 15 days, you will say, sir, I know what UPSC want. I know what is there in the syllabus. The syllabus will be like your palm. Oh, this is there, this is not there, I have to read that. Otherwise, you will be still simply going on what UPSC wants. You will be still don't know those things. So, first read the syllabus, afterwards read any of the books. Morning, I strongly advocate reading the syllabus before you starting anything. Next, how, why I said, see, for example, environment, you have got, it is in GS3, you can correlate. In GS3, you have got agriculture, you can correlate GS3. Food, like food supplies, this is a part of GS3, agriculture related. Water resources, agriculture related, they have asked about minor irrigation, all these things. Rural development, with respect to agriculture connected things. Science and technology directly given in GS3. India and world, your GS2 portion. Polity, where is that? Polity, your GS2 portion. Everything, see, like energy, they have directly given in the main syllabus, energy related things. States, they have given history and geography of states. They have given general information. Everything is very, very good information. But the thing is, you have to read it on a regular basis. You have to master these things. Moving forward, my dear students, as I always say you, and for all this trinity, India Yearbook, Economics Survey, and also your budget. First, what I say is, go through the syllabus, previous year questions, and also original copy should be there with you. If you are having, if you are reading abridged version, not a problem, read, okay. But you should have an original copy, because this is the thing which gives you confidence. If you don't have the original copy, always you'll be like not having the confidence. Because what is there in the original copy, you don't know. Getting me? And also, bird view is important. First, you go through the contents once. Go through the syllabus once. Go through the chapter once. Afterwards, you start reading. Not with first chapter. I have completed first chapter. I don't know what is there in second chapter. No. First, at least read all the chapter's name. And all these things happen, should happen only when you are in your head, the syllabus should be there. Only when even your head syllabus is there, you have to do these things. Then only your brain will assimilate these things. And also with previous year questions. Fine. Any doubt with respect to these things? Moving forward, as I told you here, it is having data at the max till December 2020. So my dear students, you have to update this with your budget. I'll be updating you if you don't update. Not a problem, but you have to update. India 2021, my dear students, I was teaching, as you are aware, I was teaching ethics till recently. Many of my students have failed and they requested me to take up this India yearbook. Sir, economic survey somehow everybody is doing. Budget somehow everybody is doing. India yearbook nobody is doing. If they are doing, they are not doing properly. Please teach this one. So I have just taken a monitorium with respect to ethics, because ethics is a subject which I love. I have written books and where I have got expertise. Just to help my students, I am taking and I am teaching India yearbook in a complete A to Z way. So I will be covering A to Z about India yearbook in this YouTube channel in the same place. And it is starting tomorrow, my dear students, 30th Jan at 10 a.m. You will be completing, starting Land and the People will complete this, because this has never changed in the last 15 years. Afterwards, we'll complete national symbols. I'll show you how you can make the things easy. You can read it afterwards. Listen to me once. But what I say, my dear students, if you can read on your own, it is the best. Even listening to my videos is not that good, because by reading, your comprehension will improve. With your comprehension, it will be very, very easy for you to solve prelims questions. And also, this is the way. In the next reading, once you have read, next reading becomes very, very easy for you. If you can read on your own, this is the best. What I do is, first, I'll go through India yearbook from first thing to till last one, A to Z. Even the difficult words. If you are finding any difficult words in the India yearbook, I'll give those things in bracket there itself, so that it will be easy for you to read very fast. So I'll be completing India yearbook starting from tomorrow, and very, very soon I'll be completing the whole India yearbook at the best possible. I have been reading India yearbook since 2006. I have got some mastery. I have cleared CIVIN 7 times and I went to interview thrice. All these are because of I dependent on three important Trinity UPSC books, that is your budget, economic survey, and also India yearbook, from which the questions are directly coming. These are the things you have to master for current affairs, then afterwards any other thing. If you have got any doubt with respect to these things, the stage is yours. You can ask me any doubt with respect to India yearbook, economic survey, budget, or any of these things. My dear students, don't forget to attend our Unacademy Comeback, which is happening on February 7th. It is a very, very important and gamified thing. Please, and you will be having a lot of fun here. Just for 60 minutes, you'll be having a lot of fun here. Take it very sportively. Don't forget to contest here. Vivek Ram Kumar Reddy, thing, any doubt for you? Okay. If you don't have any doubt, my dear students, let me conclude. My dear students, if you like our videos, please share them, subscribe them, and also wherever you encounter, my dear students, please use my promo code Buddha10 wherever you encounter an academy. Sir, will your classes be available on Telegram? No, Telegram, they won't be available. We are part of an academy team. where we'll be teaching on YouTube, and we'll be teaching on app. Because you like, if you have not yet downloaded, you can download the Unacademy app. After downloading, if they ask some code, you take my code Buddha. You can access all the free courses of even Drunal Patel sir, not only me, anyone. We are on our app. Please download the Unacademy Learners app. There you have got many, many new contents, free contents by top educators like Drunal Patel, Rakesh Verma, myself. We are teaching at Unacademy. Okay, having said that, any doubt, Vikas? These videos won't be available, but some of the material updates will be sharing on the Telegram. The Telegram group link I have shared you. That is Buddha_IAS_Ethics. So that is the link. You can join there. Okay. Any doubt, my dear students? If you don't have any doubt, let me wind up the session. My dear students, enjoy your preparation. What is that? Because okay sir, from tomorrow class on YouTube. Yes, I have downloaded the app. Oh, very fine, you are already ahead. On YouTube at 10 o'clock you will be having the class. Tomorrow two classes will be there. I will be covering two chapters, almost equal to nearly 10% of the total India Air book. Don't miss the class. Happy reading, enjoy your preparation. Let's crack it. Let's get first rank.